Welcome back to United Tradesman Academy.
All right, guys, so we got to replace this burned outlet. This is a short, quick, simple process. Really shouldn't take no more than about 10 minutes, 15 minutes at the most. So the homeowner here, they have the garage door closed. So I can't go back in and show you that I did turn the breaker off. So first thing you like to do, or first thing you should do, is turn the circuit breaker off. So at this point, I've already turned the circuit breaker off. It is off. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna test it again with my meter and we'll get to work. So, showing 0 volts. 0 volts.
Sorry about that.
It's no problem. You didn't notify me. Oh, yeah, it's okay. No worries. Okay. Shouldn't take but a second.
I'm just curious to see how bad it is.
Well, it may not show too much on the surface. It's more so probably gonna be internal, but we'll see once we take it out.
And I wanted to mention too, one of the times, this could have happened every time, but one of the three times we tried to flip the breaker, my wife was in the living room while I went to the breaker, and when I tried to flip it on, she heard like an arcing,
something like
I don't know if it was a buzz. It was more like that sound, like when the power, like a power surge, like when the power's out and they try to restore it. That's the kind of noise, like when it's attempting to restore power but it doesn't quite make it. That kind of like noise, like a, I don't know how to describe it.
Okay. All right. So let's cut this. Cut these off here. So actually, something else happened here.
What happened?
So before I take this outlet off, just come pick your head in right here. See that?
What is that? Oh, a screw fell in or something.
It went right there.
So it fell out of the box into
the... No. So this is a metal box.
Right.
So that's... This is the hot side of it. This is the hot side.
Uh-huh.
So you see that black wire?
Yeah.
So this side of the outlet is the hot side. These two screws, they're normally gold. They'll be, that's the hot side. This side over here, these screws are normally silver. So there's no voltage on these, on the neutral wires here. So when that wire was sent down in there, it touched right there. So that's what's calling it instant tripping. That's what we call that a short to ground.
Okay, so was it hot grounded wire properly?
No, it did exactly what it was supposed to do.
Oh, okay.
Meaning the circuit breaker did exactly what it was supposed to do.
Okay.
Yeah, no.
But is that actual box supposed to be set up like that? Because you were setting like gold screws one side, silver screws the other.
Well, it would have been better. So normally when you have a metal box,
yeah,
it's good to tape the outlet up.
Uh-huh.
And it's also good to turn it this way. Because if these wires, it, well, not wires. If these screws touch the metal box, it won't have the same effect like that.
Okay.
You know, so, and really, it's really dangerous because sometimes that breaker doesn't trip.
Okay.
And that box will be live. So if you come up, so if you would have came up and touched that, that cover is metal also, you would have got electrocuted.
Like lethal?
Oh yeah, most definitely.
Really?
Especially with the wet ground here. Oh yeah. Yeah, you want to, see, it's not, so there's a few things that you have to take into consideration when you're dealing with electrical shock. It's really the conditions more so than the actual shock itself, because you got water out here. You probably wouldn't have got off of it. You know, I mean, maybe, but a lot of times, see, because when you have electrical shock, your muscles spaz up. So that's why sometimes when people, they get shocked and they grabbing onto it, you can't let go because your muscles are spasming.
Right.
And so you can't let go, so you just get electrocuted.
Wow.
You know? But in this case, you know, you're not holding on to anything, so you can touch it and you feel it, so you can take your hand back. A lot of times, like I said, like if you're like this and you're locked up, you can't let go because your muscles are spasming, so you can't open your hand up.
Right.
So you just keep getting electrocuted until you just die.
That's scary because, like, I mean, I made sure that the break was out, but I kind of that could have killed me.
Oh yeah, most definitely. Especially with the rain. Especially with the rain and the water.
Yeah,
especially with the rain and water. Yep. Mm-hmm.
So we have I think two other outlets that are probably set up the exact same at the front of the house.
Mm-hmm.
Can we replace those two?
Yeah, we'll check it out. You say you have two in the front?
I think it's two.
Okay. By the front door?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. No problem.
Oh my god, I can't believe, like, is it dangerous to touch it even if the breaker is off for that circuit?
No. Only way it'd be dangerous is if it's back feeding. But see, I would have known if it was back feeding because I tested for power. There's no power here.
And the breaker would have protected me anyways because it would have kept shorting it out probably.
So, well, in this case, the breaker did what it was supposed to do. So when
but
we have
but
a short,
it cannot we, happen. It could be live.
Oh, you can have, yeah. The breaker malfunctions.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh yeah, most definitely.
Okay.
Oh yeah.
But you were saying the way that these are set up.
Yeah. Go ahead.
I was gonna say the way that these are set up. I thought you said the way that this one in particular was set up.
Yeah. So
it could fail in a way where the breaker doesn't trip.
Oh. Yeah. That's if you have a somewhat faulty breaker.
Okay.
Yeah.
But that one's new, so that should not happen.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Because sometimes the breaker won't trip.
If I had that Federal Pacific panel.
No. Well. I mean.
Because those.
It all depends. It all depends. I won't necessarily say that just because it's Federal Pacific that it wouldn't have done its job.
Right.
I mean, you can get some of the newer style breakers just have a defect from the factory.
Right.
You know, and it could possibly do the same thing.
Right.
You know, so just because it's Federal Pacific, I won't necessarily say, you know, so, yeah.
Okay.
Yep.
Do the wires look okay, or do you have to
they look okay. Or anything? Yeah, they look okay. Yeah, nothing else is melted or anything like that. Yeah, they look okay. Yep. So.
And then,
but I definitely can smell it, so.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That's scary.
Yep.
The internal outlets,
mm-hmm.
You looked at our house probably like earlier in the summer.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Do the internal outlets, do they need to be changed or taped up or whatever you were describing with the metal boxes?
Now, inside the house, they would typically use a plastic box or like a fibrous type box, which is not conductive, so should be fine on those.
Okay. Yeah. I was going to actually have you, if you have time, mm-hmm. To briefly look at one of the outlets on the inside.
Okay.
And an unrelated thing, the bottom part of the outlet doesn't ever charge anything.
Mm.
If you have time, so.
Okay.
But, and then you could look at it, how it's set up if you wanted to, like, while you're doing that.
Okay. I may have, let me check my, I got a few more people I got to go to.
Okay.
But yeah, let me get finished with this and I'll see where I'm
okay.
at. I'll check the one at the front.
I think there's two. I'm gonna go double check how many there are. I think there's just this one back here and then there's the.
Okay.
Oh, I forgot to also let you know that the hallway bathroom and the hallway closet are also on the same circuit, so those are out too.
Mm.
So, entryway, living room, and the outside.
That sucks.
Are the inside outlets just as lethal if, like, there was a short and the breaker didn't trip correctly and you touched it? Same.
Yeah, especially if the boxes are metal, yeah.
Yeah. Just touching the outside, though?
I'm sorry, say it again?
Just touching the outside of it, though, will produce the shock? Because it's a plastic cover, so I was just curious.
It depends also, too, how bad it's damaged.
Okay.
Because just like how you saw, like, this one right here mm-hmm. is melted. Sometimes the front part could be so melted that the terminals where you plug the cord in, sometimes they could be so the outside here could be so melted that if you touch this right here, the terminals are exposed and you can get electrocuted like that also. Oh, so okay. it all depends case by case.
Right.
I wouldn't say 100% yes every single time, but it all just depends on how badly it's worn out.
Right.
How badly it's damaged and melted. Yep. See how I put tape around those?
Right.
Just like that.
Yeah.
Yep. And now. These off.
We don't ever use this light, but could there be something similar going on with this thing up here?
Potentially.
Really?
Yeah, potentially. I said potentially.
Okay.
Yeah, potentially. I won't say, like I said, I won't say 100% yes. I only can say potentially because I haven't looked at it.
Okay.
So, always, until I've seen it and start, check something out, I always assume the worst. So, that's why I just say potentially, because I hate to say, oh no, and then, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, because just the age and, you know, when there's no maintenance that's been done, you know? So that's why I say it like that. All right, let's go turn the breaker on here. Okay. 120. 120 volts. Hopefully you can see that on that camera. All right, guys, so look. Sometimes a homeowner has a lot of questions. And it's good if you can explain it to where they can understand, because the way my explanation would be to another electrician wouldn't necessarily be how I would tell a homeowner. So it's good to be able to break things down in more of a layman's term, because a lot of times you can get a homeowner confused. And also too, if they get confused, they may not do what's in their best manner for their house to be safe and for them to be safe. So hey guys, look, Thank y'all for watching. We'll see you next time back at United Tradesman Academy.